The sub-indication, or the F21 fault, both tell us there isn't enough DC bus voltage for the drive to enable the output to the motor. A drive takes an AC input, rectifies it, runs it across a large capacitor to create a DC signal, which is chopped and sent out to a motor. By adjusting the chopping on the three phases, the drive can very accurately control the speed of the motor. These faults are telling us that this DC level is too low for the chopper to do its job. Sub says there isn't enough DC voltage to enable the output when the motor isn't running. Fault 21 occurs when the motor is running and the DC bus drops too low. And it's easy enough to demo. Since this is just a rectified signal, it's directly proportional to the input voltage. The lower the input voltage, the lower the DC bus. So I just inserted a variac here so I can change the amplitude of the voltage into the drive. Let's monitor parameter 4, which shows us the DC bus voltage. I have this voltmeter connected to the line voltage going into this drive. I'll slowly lower the input voltage, and when it gets too low, the drive issues a sub-indication. Looks like the DC bus was right at 200 volts when that happened. If we look in the programming manual, we see that the undervoltage threshold is 200 volts, which agrees with what we just found. Bingo. If I raise the input voltage, the drive automatically comes back. You don't have to reset anything because the drive wasn't running when this happened. This time, let's hit run. The drive is running at the default min speed of 3 Hz. If I lower the input voltage until the DC bus hits 200 volts, we get fault 21. Again, this tells us the DC bus fell too low to keep the output enabled while the drive was running. This time, if I raise the input voltage, the fault doesn't go away. You have to manually reset the fault and then hit run again to get the motor moving. Which makes sense. You don't want the motor to start spinning again until you know everything's safe, right? So that's it. If you get a sub or an F21 message, it usually means the input voltage isn't high enough to get the DC bus to 200 volts. So just put a voltmeter across the input to the drive and see if it looks reasonable. Now I'm using single phase here, so it only took one measurement. If you're using a three-phase supply, then you'll want to measure all three phases. Now, while that's usually the issue, there are a couple other things that can give you these undervoltage messages. Make sure you have the right drive for your input voltage. For example, you might have a 220-volt drive, but a 120-volt line input. So be sure to check the drive's label. I know it seems silly to mention it, but sometimes it's the simple things that trip us up. If you're using a three-phase supply, there might be something goofy with the phasing of the input voltage. So get an oscilloscope and verify that all three phases look correct relative to each other. If you think you might have power line issues, consider using one of these guys. They provide full power system analysis of single phase, two phase, three phase three wire, and three phase four wire systems. And you can configure and communicate with them via Modbus RTU. And they even have alarm outputs. Very cool. Finally, if none of those are the issue, then use one of AutomationDirect's free award-winning support options to contact tech support. There could be something wrong with the drive. Click here to learn more about the WEG CFW300 Variable Frequency Drive, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.